Hey everyone, Digital David here. Today in this video, we're going to be looking at the Western Digital MyCloud Home Duo personal cloud device. They did send me this product review, but any opinion expressed in this video is strictly my own. That being said, if you're interested in this product, the link to it will be in my video description below. Please go ahead, check it out, do your shopping from there. Here's how it comes packaged to you in a really nice retail box. I love Western Digital's packaging. They do just such a great job with their designs, their colors, and their product photography. So a little bit about this product. It is a 4 terabyte drive, but you can see the box even explains to you it's two terabytes configured in RAID 1, which is mirroring. So you're going to have 2 terabytes of storage, and then the other 2 terabytes of storage are going to be a backup mirrored image of your files, photos, videos, that sort of thing. So you never have to worry about losing anything ever again because this is configured in a way to back up your backup or to back up your cloud storage. So I'm really excited to go ahead and open this up for you guys and to set it up. So let's get it unboxed. Here are all the package contents. First up, you have your setup guide right here. I'm gonna be blocking a code at the bottom with my fingers, but you're gonna have one for your device as well. There's 4 steps right there. Basically, just plug it in and go to that address on your device. Then they give us a patch cord, they give us a power supply, and last but not least, the device itself. This is compatible with Mac, PC, iOS, and Android, so you're not gonna have any problem setting this up. It's designed to be super plug and play for you. This has a great weight to it. It's pretty heavy, but I like that. It kind of gives it a quality feel to me just from the weight alone. But I love the design and everything about this. The white and then the gray pattern on the bottom. So this looks really cool. Has their logo on it right there. And then on the back side, we can see we got 2 USB ports right there. Your networking port and then your power plug right there. So everything looks great. There's even a button at the top too, and it looks like we're gonna have a little reset button right there if we ever need to push that as well for the device. So now guys, after looking at this, let's go ahead, plug it in and set it up. So off camera, we got the device plugged in directly to our router. Then we need to visit the mycloud.com/hello web browser link to finish setup. So once you go to that link, you'll be prompted to create a profile if you don't already have one. Then you'll be at this screen where you may already have your device auto-populated right here, or you're gonna have to enter the code. So go ahead and enter your code now. So once you have your device information entered, you'll select search, then it'll say all done. You'll be at this screen where you can download the iOS or Android app as well as a desktop app, and you can even continue to MyCloud Home for web. So for this video, we're gonna go ahead, we're just gonna go continue to MyCloud Home for web. You're gonna get a very similar experience on all of these apps. So let's go ahead, let's select that. And here we go, we're already into the device right now. So let's explore some of its great features. So let's go navigate down really quick to the settings tab. We can see our account info right here. We can add another user. You simply just share this device with them via email and they're gonna have access to whatever private space and storage you give them. We can add another device. It's as simple as finding that code right here and setting it up. And then last but not least, let's go look at our actual MyCloud Home Duos settings right here. So we can change the name, see the storage type. We can see the space available right here. We have 1.75 terabytes out of 2. Now you may be thinking, well, David, didn't you say this is a 4 terabyte version? Yes, it is. And remember how I talked about it comes configured as RAID 1 right out of the box. So that's gonna withhold 2 terabytes from you because it needs that last 2 terabytes to back up your first 2 terabytes because it's gonna make a mirror image for you. So if one drive fails, you still have all the data on the other drive. So then we can view software version, analytics, our users, and our configuration right here. So let's go ahead, let's click on that. You see it says RAID 1, but we have another option. So we can access all 4 terabytes if we want, but the risk is if either drive fails, you're gonna lose the data. So you just gotta figure out what works best for your needs. Right now, RAID 1 would be great for me. I'm not too worried about running out of space for any of my data. And we can do all this other stuff right here from the device. So now let's go back from the settings tab. We're back home. You can see we have a family folder, so we can add some files, drag and drop to upload. So this is really cool. It's just telling you you're not limited to just photos and videos. You can add files and folders and stay organized right here. We can put photos in right here. You can view them by photos or videos. And they even have a little calendar right here to search by date. And they have a search bar up top. You can type in and look for your documents. They got a big blue add photos button right there. Then we have some other features that are going to be contingent upon you having the most recent version of the app downloaded. So then you could do shared albums with other people. And then you can even just do your shared folders as well again. So we got albums and we got shared right here. So again, we got to have the most recent version downloaded on either iOS or Android to be able to use those great features. But again, we can do so much even without the mobile app right here just to create folders. And then we can select what we want to do with the folder. So we got the family folder right here. We can select share, delete, move, or rename. So let's go ahead, let's select share, and then we can send a link for view only. So now people that have that link can view what is in there for you. So I think that's a really neat feature too. If you want to share some photos, some videos, that sort of thing, people can view them, but they can't delete them and hurt any of your precious files and belongings. So I'm really impressed with this device. It's going to be perfect for your own cloud solution. And I just think it's so easy. It's simple. It's drag and drop. Anybody can use it right here. So what's really nice, if you're not super tech and you don't know how to set this stuff up, this is going to be a solution you're going to want to heavily consider. If you are big into NAS and all of those storage options, you're going to want to look at this video, see those settings, and make the best decision for yourself. You may want something with a little bit more control to really dive into those features and configure it how you want. Last but not least, I wanted to show you really quick this Do More tab section right here in the top left-hand corner. Look at all these other features you can enable for your My Cloud home device. We got channels DVR right there. You could just select enable. We have Plex right here too. So with some supporting information and help for you. We have social cloud and input if you want to link your public cloud accounts like Dropbox or Google Drive. We have Alexa skills for your My Cloud device as well. Same with IFTTT. So again, they all have supporting information, contact, and documentation for you. There we go for all these great features. So be sure to check those out as well and see if this has what you want and need. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you're interested in more Western Digital products, I have a couple more videos on my channel. Be sure to check them out as well. If you could go ahead, hit that like button for me and subscribe to my channel. I have new content coming out daily and I don't want you to miss any of it. Please don't hesitate to reach out with any questions, comments, or concerns below. I'd be happy to answer them for you or point you in the right direction. If you're interested in this product, the link to that again is in my video description below. So go ahead, check it out, and do your shopping from there. If you could give me a follow on social media as well, that would be awesome. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. You can message me on WeChat. Check out my website and join my free newsletter. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in my next video.